The point P is on the unit circle. If the y-coordinate of P is -2/3 and P is in the fourth quadrant, what is the x-coordinate? So there are a couple ways to approach this problem. If this is the unit circle, quadrant 4 would be down here. Notice where the x-coordinates are positive and the y-coordinates are negative. And again, we're given that the y-coordinate is -2/3. So if this is one unit here, if we divide this into thirds, the point we're looking for would be this point here on the unit circle where the x-coordinate is unknown and the y-coordinate is -2/3. Well, because we're talking about the unit circle, the center is at the origin with the coordinates 0, 0, which means h and k are both 0. And because we have the unit circle, we know the radius is equal to 1. So looking at the equation of a circle here, we would just have x squared plus y squared equals 1 squared. So the equation of the unit circle would just be x squared plus y squared equals 1. So now we can just substitute -2/3 for y and then solve for x. And because we're in the fourth quadrant, we want to make sure that we use the positive solution for x. The other option would be to sketch a reference triangle for this point on the unit circle. For example, if we sketch the radius to that point, and then sketch a perpendicular segment to the horizontal axis here, this would be our reference triangle in red, where we'd label this length x, and this length here, because we're in the fourth quadrant where y is negative, we'd label this -2/3, and then the hypotenuse would be the radius, which we know is 1, because we're on the unit circle. So here, if we use the Pythagorean theorem, we'll get the same results using this equation here once we substitute -2/3 for y. We'd have x squared plus -2/3 squared equals 1. So x squared plus, we know a negative times a negative is positive, and 2 squared is 4 and 3 squared is 9. This is 4/9 equals 1. Subtracting 4/9 on both sides would give us x squared equals, I'm going to write 1 as 1 over 1 minus 4/9. Obtaining a common denominator of 9, we'd multiply 1 over 1 by 9 over 9. So we have x squared equals, this would be 9/9 minus 4/9 or 5/9. And then we'll take the square root of both sides to solve for x. Remember, we have both a positive and negative solution for x here. So we have x equals plus or minus the square root of 5/9 is equal to the square root of 5 divided by the square root of 9. Well, the square root of 9 is equal to 3. So we have x equals plus or minus the square root of 5 divided by 3. But again here, because we're in the fourth quadrant where the x-coordinates are positive, we only use the positive solution here. So the x-coordinate would be x equals positive square root of 5 divided by 3. So the point would have coordinates square root of 5 divided by 3, comma, -2/3. Now before we go, let's go ahead and get our decimal approximation for x. But remember, unless we're asked around, we should not use a decimal approximation. But as an example, let's go ahead and round this to 3 decimal places. So we have second x squared brings up the square root, 5, close parenthesis, and then divided by 3. If you have a newer TI-84, you'd have to hit the right arrow to get out from underneath the square root. If we round to 3 decimal places, notice how the 5 is in the third decimal place. The next digit is a 3, which indicates we round down. This would be approximately 0.745. But again, we do not want to round unless we're told to. I hope you found this helpful.